What is up, guys? My name's Loverfella, and welcome back to Ark Survival Evolved. So today we're hanging out on top of the lighthouse above our base, and I actually want to show you guys a cool design idea I had for defense. So as you guys know, a lot of raids happen where people come into your base and they build fobs right outside your front door, and they push in and push in and push in, and eventually they're inside your base. As you can see, it's not really hard to get into our base because all I have to do is build a fob like right in our front doorstep and they're in. So what I want to do is work on some more defense outside, something a lot of people kind of overlook, and a weird one I want to do is actually build it in this lighthouse. So before you crucify me and tell me that this lighthouse takes 6x damage, which it may or may not do, it's still a really, really, really cool spot. Oh, getting a 5 didn't work there. It's still a really cool spot because this structure is impossible to demolish, right? No one can demolish this structure. Dang it, the wireless generator doesn't reach the roof. I might have to get another one up here. But the plan is, there are these little windows on the side, right? If you walk down it, little windows, and I just want to put our turrets in these windows and just have them shooting out like that. So we can have these turrets hidden in here. They're going to have to break every single one of these turrets. Let's do this on... This is a nice UI menu, by the way. Let's just do player and tame. That's fine for this one. We'll have a nice mix. And we'll put quite a few bullets into these. I want about 1,000 in each. We'll do 500 each. This seems good. I don't think people are going to be tanking these for too long. But it's going to be really awkward to break it, because you have to literally walk in here and break each one individually. You can't just walk to the basement and, like, you know, break the generator and you'll get them all. You're right. It's just not that easy. Let's uncheck that. Except, so it's a really cool design. It's a really cool base defense. I'm going to need more bullets because I have way more turrets than bullets. But for now, what I want to do is just kind of go around the outside, see how far down I can get, you know, get all my settings set up and everything. And we'll keep this on players only. I'm just going to alternate. That way, if they have like a Trenodon, it'll kill it. And this window's pretty big. So maybe we'll put 2 of them in this window. Maybe even 3, actually, if we can fit through here. Let's see what we can do. But what our plan is here for this crazy design is they're not going to be able to build a fob up here, because if they did, it'd be really hard for us to raid it. So I'm like, actually, I'm going to do that later. I can make the S plus, I can make a gun to like really quickly go through and label everything how I want it to be. So again, guys, if you want to join us, links are in the description. All you have to do is join our Discord and you'll get in that way. And it's super fun and super easy. So yeah, it's just going to wind down the whole tower. And number one thing I'm going to have to do is just make sure the Jenny, I don't know if that's going to shoot or not. Maybe if I can pick that up and put it up a little bit higher. Number one thing, though, is just protect our generator. Make sure no one's able to raid it, you know? Like, if people can break that, this whole thing is useless. So I'm going to have to go back, patch that up a little bit, make sure it's a little bit more secured up there. Oh. And, you know, it's funny, because I just go somewhere and people just show up. Like, I'm making this a project. I've not announced to anyone that I'm doing this. And there's, like, 5 people here. So you can guarantee they're going to start changing settings and setting this up for us. So it's pretty cool to see. But... 3 here. I like the triple areas. I like that a lot. Let's get one over here as well. See if anyone's complaining. You know the lighthouse? You know the lighthouse fell out the window? Let's keep on going down here. Get them all the way down. This is going to be really good defense. Like, they can't build up here now. So I like it. I'm going to see it from the outside though once we're done, and it's going to look a lot cooler. So I'm going to keep on going, guys. Keep on adding these around the outside. Not going to make you watch. Oh, it's not powered. Okay. So it looks like we're going to have to get a generator on that floor as well as the top floor in case both of them and come back. So I'll see you guys in a minute. Alright guys, we're back inside of the lighthouse right now, and what the reason is we're doing this is not only is it a good way to defend things, it's also a good backup space to get to. It's also a really good spot for them to build a fob. So the main reason I'm here building right now is because this is where I would build a fob if I'm raiding someone. It would be so hard for us to break in and clear this. We can't just suicide bomb it, because you have to break every turret individually or every single generator inside the whole base. And so, I don't know if our generator range will reach down here, will it? Oh snap, it will. All right that's some good placement by me up there. So we're just gonna put a couple more on the outside around the area around here. I still have 10 left, so I want to just really secure this the best I can. But if you look at it, if you're flying by it, you got turrets out of almost every single window, and I'm gonna run through it one more time, make sure I didn't miss any. And I also want to check that I have the generator range extended to max up here, because if I don't and I extend it to max, that might give me a little bit of extra range. That way I can place some on the top floor, because that's really gonna help us if I can. So check this out. I don't think I did, honestly. Increase to maximum. It's gonna take a lot more gas for sure. We've got like 1500 gas and we have like millions of base, so I don't see that being a problem. And I should be able to just place a couple up here now. Should be able to power them on. Probably just like 2 per wing. We don't want to get them too close, too dense together. Because if I do that, that means a suicide bomber could potentially take them out a little bit easier than I would like. Let's get one there. right on the edge. So this is cool. This is a cool build, cool turret tower. But really, again, the reason for this is because it's going to prevent people from building a fob here, and it's going to be a nice backup point. If we have to retreat, we can come here. You know, it's not perfect, it's not ideal, but it's gonna help a lot. So that's really why we built this. Two more turrets left. Let's go run down, make sure we didn't miss any. Got one there, got one there, got one there. Like, this is cool, dude. 360 degree. And I'm going to enclose that too, that generator, with metal so they can't snipe it or shoot it with tech or whatever it is that they want to do. Because I'm sure blue trap's going to be getting tech because they are massive. And it looks like there's a big swing going on right now. I think red trap is getting a lot of momentum. Red trap's really doing well. And so part of me thinks we're going to come out ahead once the server is over. I just think the lover family is too strong. I don't think they're going to be able to take us down. So, you know, maybe I'm getting a little cocky, but this is a pretty good looking base right now. Obviously, we're just going to need a ton of bullets for it. And then I want to add sniper towers, add all that stuff to it. You know, beds. Actually, we have sleeping bags in here, and then vaults and chests and all kinds of cool stuff. And then really just keep on working on it, keep on flushing it out as much as I can, because since it's so close to our base, it's going to be a really nice secondary place to get to. Also, shout out to whoever gave me this bird. It's freaking awesome. Alright, after a long and excruciating journey with what may be the lowest level mantis you're ever going to see, we finally made it over to where wood is. And so we need to get wood for charcoal. And so literally we're just going to run through here and deforest this entire place. Now the funny thing is, when I started Ark about maybe 2 years ago almost, when it first came out. It's very dark, by the way. Sorry, I hope you can see. But when I first started Ark about 2 years ago, I remember thinking that trees would not respawn. So I thought, if I cut down every tree in the game, they wouldn't come back. So one of my strategies was actually walking around and breaking trees near bases, because I thought it would like make them want to like quit or something. So that's like how I used to play the game. So it's a good question. What's your noobiest thing you've ever done in the game? Like for me, it's got to be that. Like I remember one day I got on, had like a primitive stone because I didn't know how to make metal like when I first started. And I was literally walking up to bases and just deforesting everything. And I was like, that's it, dude. I beat him. He's gone. Like these massive metal bases. And I would just slowly do it. Stone hatchet. No movement speed. Didn't know how to level up. And that's how I got started on here. So follow your dreams, man. That's what dreams are made of. All right, so that's a good amount of charcoal. Oh, jeez. Oh, whoa. What the? Holy. Oh my gosh, that thing just murdered me in like 3 seconds. Well, guys, that's today's episode. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to click subscribe, and I'll see you all tomorrow.